Good morning, diners, and welcome to another collapse wake-up call here on the Doomsday Diner. And this morning, as you can see, I've changed around my set a little bit, and we're going to have a little talk about all that here in a minute. This is a work in progress, you see. And people expect it to be perfect right out of the box. And it's not, okay? It's not even close. I've had audio problems, I've had connection problems, I've had to figure out workarounds to various things. It's a challenge, you know? And I'm doing a lot of this from scratch, you know? A decent photographer, you know, I did that in my youth. I was a photography editor for the Columbia Spectator, and I did a lot of photography as a hobby for many years, but I haven't done editing, and I have very little experience with video other than shooting pictures or vids of my jimmies when I was coaching, before I was crippled. And those things were never more than 2 or 3 minutes. They didn't have much talking in them, not much audio. So they were very easy, you know. This is a lot harder. And I get advice and recommendations from people who never use the stuff. You know what I mean? I mean, give me a break. You know, a few certifiable experts have weighed in, and I do take their suggestions into my, you know, thought process and try to figure out a way to do it and make it better, and I'm going to keep making the thing better, okay? Okay. That's all on this. I don't want to hear any more about how the audio sucked or how I should use this piece of software or that piece of software or this system or that system. I'm working on it, okay? Okay. Now, for the topic for today. We finally had a denouement of sorts with the Julian Assange case. He's the WikiLeaks executive, one of the founders, who spent the last 7 years in the Ecuadorian embassy. And, you know, that was not the best place to hole up, but I suppose he didn't have much choice at the time. And so, you know, he was stuck there for 7 years. And this week, the London police, at the behest of the Ecuadorian government, who finally was fed up with Julian for one reason or another, dropped on in there and forcibly evicted him and arrested him. Now, this scene was not all that nice. You know, Julian is looking a little ragged. He's got a nice long beard, even longer than mine, and he got, you know, dragged around. He kind of fought it a little bit. The arrest, insofar as that was possible, with, you know, a half a dozen bobbies bobbing about him to drag him to the paddy wagon. And they dumped his ass in there, and now he is in a jail cell somewhere in London, awaiting the decision of various courts on what will happen to him. An equally important problem is what's happening to Julian Assange's cat. Okay? That's not Schrodinger's cat. That's Assange's cat. apparently, the cat is no longer to be found in the Ecuadorian embassy. But unlike Julian, whose whereabouts we know, he's in a London jail cell, the cat's whereabouts are a mystery. It is unknown if the cat was given to a shelter, or whether relatives took it, or whether it was euthanized. Or maybe, you know, some Chinese restaurant is using it in a meal. I don't know. But, you know, that's a little humorous aside to the whole Julian Assange problem, okay? Which is a, you know, a running problem. And let me shut off the audio here. We don't need to listen to the audio.
That cat was given the Julian Assange in May.
Okay, now you can just listen to me. Now you can still see what's going on the screen, though. And you can look it up on YouTube yourself. I think this one is from Russia Today, maybe? I don't know who put this one out. But the United States, the fascist states of America, as I like to refer to it, has wanted to arrest this guy, charge him with sedition and treason, which treason is kind of impossible because he's not a citizen of the United States. Okay, he is, I think, a citizen of Oz. Although he also has some Swedish connections as well. And Sweden may also want to extradite him for a supposed rape allegations. The charges of which they dropped a couple of years ago, but now may reinstate now that they can serve him with papers, that he needs to show up in a Swedish court and answer the accusations that were leveled against him by probably a couple of paid-off people. But I'm speculating there. I don't know what the situation was, but it's all rather suspicious, of course, that he would get arrested or charged with rape right during all this WikiLeaks hoopla that was going on at the time. And, you know, what has occurred since then? Well, Hillary Clinton, who had her emails hacked, would like to see Julian back here to quote-unquote face justice. And then the most of the right wing that is against the free dissemination of ideas via journalism and is trying to put the kibosh on free speech. Most of those folks would like to see Julian hauled in and burned at the stake too. Okay? About the only people that are coming out in support of Julian are other journalists, people like John Pilger, a Pulitzer Prize winning a journalist from the Vietnam War era, who also has produced many videos. Amy Goodman from Democracy Now. You may remember her during the protests over the pipeline that occurred and her arrest at that time. And then Chris Hedges, another Pulitzer Prize winner, has come out in support of them. For basically everybody who's on the left side of the aisle, to one extent or another, is in support. And all the people on the right wing, the conservatives, libertarians, all those people, they're anti-Julian. Myself, one should obviously realize I am very much in support of Julian, and hoping he extricates himself from this one way or the other. I have a certain amount of sympathy for him in the sense that he was trapped in two or three rooms of that Ecuadorian embassy, unable to leave for 7 years. And, you know, there is a commentary from the Ecuadorians that he was a slob, that he didn't take care of his cat, etc. And he comes out looking all disheveled with the long beard and everything. You know, if you've ever been housebound for a little while, you really don't care about shaving anymore. And you start to go a little stir crazy. And, you know, I was only housebound here this first time for, you know, the winter, you know, basically since November. So November, December, January, February, March, April, about 6 months. Julian was stuck in this place for 7 years. I mean, that's got to drive you a little bonkers, okay? If he's come out with any amount of sanity, that's a pretty good result. So, what's going to happen to Julian Assange? What's going to happen to WikiLeaks? Those questions are still up in the air. If I was him, I would kind of hope that the Swedes actually get an extradition order and take precedence over the extradition order that the FSoA is going to put out on the guy and hand over to the Brits. The Brits, of course, being completely in the pocket of the military-industrial complex and the empire, as it were, the Anglo-American empire, will do whatever the FSoA asks. What the Swedes will do at this point, that's an open question, and they're probably not quite as much in the pocket of the FSoA as the Brits are, but they also are not completely innocent. And anybody or any country political system that's part of NATO is not completely innocent. And on a final note, with a little bit of hilarity, the clown in chief, Donald Trumpovetsky, during the campaign, he just loved WikiLeaks. You know, I mean, he loved it. You know why? Because WikiLeaks was damaging the candidacy of his prime rival of the time, Hillary Clinton. And now, though, his press secretary shows up at a meeting and says, "Oh no, he was only joking." A real joke there. You know, he was lauding WikiLeaks throughout the campaign. And basically, when anybody is reporting news that serves El Trumpo's interest, then he loves him. So he loves Fox News, he loves Sean Hannity, but he hates CNN and MSNBC and the New York Times, who I think he predicts will not last another 6 years. The New York Times has been around for many presidents. They could go down, because everything is going down, but I don't think they'll go down before Trumpovetsky. So we'll just have to see how this all plays out with time. All right. I'll wrap it up for tonight. I hope this particular episode was to your liking. If it wasn't, you can take a flying fuck at a rolling donut. All right. And, you know, if you want to discuss this with me, mano a mano, you have to strap one hand behind your back because I have one crippled arm, then please do. And we're there every day in the Diner Forum, and you can find the location on the web in the scrolling credits, which are going to come right after I stop talking. And that's all the doom. this time, until next time, here on the Collapse Cafe of the Doomsday Diner. Hasta la pasta.